Hey everybody, what's going on? Borderlands here, back inside of Borderlands, the pre-sequel, and today I have the Nisha build that I have been talking about for the past few days now, and it is finally here. The guides for the builds will be coming out a little bit faster than previous, but anyway, we are finally here with Nisha, the ultimate glass cannon. She can kill enemies before they even have a chance to attack. That is the whole idea behind this build. And I will go ahead and go over how to acquire each of the different items for this build as well, because a lot of people left comments on my Wilhelm builds like, how do I get this gun? How do I get this shield? Well, I'm going to teach you all that here today. So, anyway, first off, what we're going to have is the Thorny Old Rosie. This is going to be your primary weapon. Now, you'll notice that it's level 48, and that's because you get this from the beating the final mission of TVHM. So the item will always be level 48. There isn't a way to get level 50 unless you use Gibb. So we're going to be using a level 48 version here, which is more than enough. And the reason we're using the Rosie over any other laser is because of that 518% continuous damage bonus. That is huge, considering that most lasers are around 200%. Anyway, the other item that we're going to be using here is going to be the right sizing bitch. Now, the only reason that we use this is if we run out of ammo for our Rosie. That's really the only reason that you will be switching to this item. Granted, it can kill enemies just as quick, but I don't like it because I'd rather a Rosie. Anyway, so this item can be attained from beating TVHM, and the bitch can be obtained from killing Drongo in the Rough Love side quest, which is in my legendary weapons guide. Anyway, let's go ahead and go over shields, grenade mods, Oz kits, and class mods. Now, for your shield, you can use pretty much whatever you want. This one is pretty much completely up to you. I use a slammer, not so much for the capacity, because I can kill enemies before they can really hit me. But the reason I use it is because of that booster. If they do hit me, there's a chance that they could potentially drop a slammer, which will increase my movement speed, my fire rate, and my reload speed. But I'm mostly doing this for the movement speed potential increase, not so much for the fire rate and reload speed, because we're going to have plenty of that in our skill tree. And you get the slammer by just coming into Concordia through Moxie's back door. Now, for the class mod, you can go for one of two things. It really depends on how badly you want to break the game. For this gameplay, I'm going to be going through a high rolling crap shooter class mod. This is +6 into Tombstone and +5 into Trick Shot. There's also another one that gives you points into Unchained, but I find the extra fire rate to be completely overkill, so don't really go into it. The next thing is that this will give you a little bit of an increase into your critical damage. Now, if you want to completely break the game, you can go for a Celestial Lawbringer class mod. This will give you a ton of different bonuses. The most notable ones are going to be Ruthless, Quick Shot, and Wanted. Not Wanted. Baru, do you even remember how class mods work? Bonafide Grit. I'm sorry, I'm bad. Anyway, another thing that's really good about this is a 12.5% showdown damage is converted to health, which basically means you won't die, ever, because you're going to be doing a lot of damage in showdown. But anyway, those are the three main skills that you'll be using. Bottled Courage, Law, and Wanted really are not used at all in this build. And you can get the Celestial Lawbringer from killing the raid boss. Please use quotation marks when referring to the raid boss. And you can get the High Rolling Crapshooter from any of the vendors or just farming chests. I recommend the Felicity chest farm because there are 4 chests in there, and it's really easy to get class mods from right there. And now for our Oz kit. I like to go with an acrobatic Oz kit, not so much for melee damage, but more for the air control and the speed boost amount. A 50% speed boost after you do a slam, which is pretty much every time I jump, so having a constant 50% movement speed buff is really nice on Nisha, especially when you've already got a 20% constant buff from your kill skill. So, and the air control is really nice too, if you need to like make a turn to the left or the right. And you can get this acrobat class mod just like just doing a chest farm while you're trying to also get your crapshooter. Now let's go ahead and go over the spec here. So the spec that we're going to be using is a little bit of a mix of Fan the Hammer and Rifle Woman. Now, we're not going to actually pick up the skill for Fan the Hammer, and we're going to explain why we spec where we spec. So first off, we're going to go into Saddle Up. Not so much for the damage, although it is very nice, but the main reason we go for this is for the movement speed. Nisha needs to be very mobile. As I said, the Acrobat class mod is very nice, but this way we'll have basically a constant 70% instead of 50%, allowing you to get to your next target and pack of enemies very quickly, because you will actually have a hard time locating enemies because you're killing them so fast. Next up is Ruthless. This will increase your showdown time by 0.5 seconds every time you get a kill. And this goes along with the increased movement speed, as well as a skill that will be later down the tree called High Noon. The longer that you're in your showdown, the more damage that you'll be dealing. You get an increase of 15% gun damage every second that you're in showdown. So for every 2 kills that you get an extra 15% gun damage, which is really nice. And near the end of your showdown, you're going to end up one-shotting enemies. Now, we put 1 point into Bottled Courage, mostly because we just want to get to the next tier of skills here. Magnificent 6 does nothing, and the Short Fused Kill skill does meaningless damage compared to your gun, so don't really spec into it. So I just throw 1 point in here. Or you can throw a point into Short Fuse if you want to. It's really up to you. Next up, we go into Faster and You. This is used for the increased reload speed and fire rate, so that way you have as little downtime as possible when firing. Not that you're really going to run out of ammo or have to reload mid-fight, but still, having that increased reload speed and fire rate is really nice. And then obviously the High Noon, like we said, because of the Ruthless combination. Now let's go ahead and go into the Riflewoman tree. For the first tier, we go into Bonafide Grit, not so much for the health regeneration, but for the critical hit damage. Like I said, this is a full glass cannon type build, and we want to get every little bit of damage that we can. We ignore Snapshot because accuracy and recoil reduction are useless on Nisha, because most of your time is going to be spent inside of Showdown, where you have perfect accuracy and no recoil. So putting points in here is a waste of your time. Next, we go 5 out of 5 inside of Quick Shot for the extra gun damage and fire rate after a reload, which you're going to be reloading a lot. Usually, you're going to reload in between every single pack of enemies. That way, you can keep this buff up at all times. Now, we go into Unchained, mostly because we really don't have other places to put skill points, and having an extra fire rate bonus is nice, but there's really nowhere else you can put your points because Crack Shot isn't going to do much of anything, and hot leaded is useless since you're using a shock and ice weapon. Fistful of Bullets doesn't do much considering these are already high magazine weapons, so we go ahead and throw 1 point into Impatience for the extra reload speed every time you get a kill, which you're going to be getting a lot of kills with your magazines, so the reload is going to be non-existent. Next up, we have Tombstone, a very major skill here. This is a kill skill that after you kill an enemy, anywhere you hit the enemy has a chance to be instead registered as a critical hit. This does take into effect any critical hit buffs that you have, so your critical hit damage from Bonafide Grit and anything else you might have, like your class mod, will benefit from Tombstone, which is the main key skill here in this entire build. Next, we have Trick Shot. Your bullets that hit walls or other objects have a chance to ricochet towards nearby enemies. I'm not going to lie, I picked this up so I can trick shot the cryophobia. I'm going to be dead serious here. That's the reason I pick up the skill, so I can trick shot a cryophobia. Anyway, it's nice to have to hit enemies around corners, but it's not really necessary considering you're going to kill them anyway. As soon as they pop up their face, they're going to die. And you'll see why here a little bit. And then for our final skill, we have the Unforgiven. This will make it so that anytime you hit an enemy, it will ricochet to a nearby enemy, dealing 10% of weapon damage per hit. And also, after assuming, like, by some miracle, if they survive the onslaught of your attacks, they will then explode. The only enemy that's going to really survive this is the raid boss, and even then, he's going to have a hard time. But the Unforgiven is mostly just so you can keep ricocheting to new enemies, because that 10% weapon damage to ricochet to a new enemy is enough to kill an enemy at times, depending on what kind of enemy you're starting on and what you're chaining to. If you're starting on a badass and chaining to a lesser enemy, the lesser enemy will die from that 10% weapon damage, which is why we want to have this. So this is pretty much makes up our skill tree here. We don't put any points inside of law and order because they are a complete waste. Order will not do anything for me, and law just, like I said, won't provide any sort of bonus that is actually beneficial. The melee damage is not used, and the shield capacity is also not used because we won't be taking too much damage. And again, we'll be using the Rosie, the Bitch, Slammer, which is completely interchangeable for whatever you want to use. The Crap Shooter, which if you want to break the game, Lawbringer. And then the Acrobatic Oz Kit. So I want to thank you all for watching this. This has been my Nisha guide. I'm going to go ahead and switch over to the gameplay of this build now. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. Help support me in what I do. And don't forget to subscribe for future content. Thank you all for watching. And let's jump into the gameplay now. I'll catch you all in the next video. Later.
Hands where I can see them. Just want to dance around in it. Stand where I can see you!
I'm exposed!